The fuck? Why is Cycles making videos about the Naruto timeline? Everybody knows the Naruto and Boruto timeline, so why is he making a video? Well, let me explain, okay? So since I started making Naruto and Boruto videos, a lot of people in the comment section have been asking me, you know, about the timeline and where the anime goes into the timeline, as well as how things fit into the timeline. So this is my explanation, okay? So whenever people ask me this question, I will link this video. Okay, cool. So basically, right, let's start at the chart here, which has been revealed, you know, officially. Okay, now for those people who actually do your research, if you did, you would find this out. But yeah, here's my little explanation, you know, explaining the chart and what goes on. Okay, so at the start here, we can see Naruto trying a fist bump, which is a fucking fail, because who would fist bump a fictional character, right? So yeah, you can see the two Itachi novels here, and I will say that it has been adapted into the anime, but not every single thing has been adapted into there. Okay, there was a ninja called Mukaiko Hinata who unlocked the Byakugan in one eye. He's a distant relative, but you know, blood dilution was introduced in here, and that is why, you know, he was struggling to unlock the Byakugan in both eyes, so he was able to unlock it into one eye. Okay, so you know, that is something that was introduced in the novels, as well as Fugaku Uchiha's Mangekyo Sharingan, alright? So that came into the anime and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, little bits of details, you know, were hidden within the novel. Okay, so if you really want a lot of information, you can check that out. And also, you know, we have a few things here, and here we have, this is chapter 699, which happened, you know, when we see Naruto and Sasuke fight and all that kind of stuff, right? So yeah, that is when that happens. And then we have the Kakashi novel. Okay, so the Kakashi novel talks about the blood prison, and the thing about the blood prison is that we have Mui, who actually exists. So for the people who don't know who Mui is a I think he's the lord of the blood prison, who keeps everyone in check with his Tenro, which actually exists. Okay, so Mui exists and he actually died. Now the thing about this novel, right, is that Naruto was mentioned to have been there, as well as the leaf cooperating with the cloud. So this is like a nod to the movie in a way. Okay, so Mui is dead and all that kind of stuff, and this is where we were introduced to the Shiden, okay, Kakashi's new lightning jutsu, right? Because he cannot use the Chidori anymore because he does not have the Sharingan, you know, to help him increase his accuracy. After that comes the Shikamaru novel, and it has already been adapted into the anime. So yeah, the Shikamaru arc, where he was trying to chase Gengo and him trying to ask Temari on a date, also happened. So we can, you know, classify that as canon, okay? Because the product of, you know, them going on a date and all that kind of stuff led to Shikadai, okay? So yeah, one thing we do learn is that, you know, kids are not delivered by birds, okay? So yeah, that's me being stupid, okay? Cool. So next one is the last Naruto the movie. Every Naruhina fan knows what happened in this movie, okay? But what I will say about the novels and the movies is that it is similar to the whole Harry Potter thing, okay? Or at least movie adaptations to books. What happens is that there were more details as to what happens to characters and what they think within the novels or the books compared to what happens in the movie. Because in the movie, there's a limited amount of time that they have to create, or at least a limited amount of patience that people have to actually watch the movie. So you know, they cannot include every single detail in there. So after the last happens, Naruto and Hinata start dating, and then we have the Sakura one, where, you know, there's a little manga chapters which came after the last, where we see Naruto and Hinata dating, and Naruto was, you know, struggling to pay for food, right? And then Hinata was like, oh, okay, let's go to Ichiraku Ramen, because she used her Byakugan to check Naruto's pockets, right, to see his wallet anyway, to see whether he has enough dough. But you know, for the person who saved the entire planet, you know, he's poor, which does not make no fucking sense, because he got a lot of gifts which he could have resold. I mean, if it was me, right, I would have resold that in a way, which is rude, but you know, what are you gonna do with the presents, right? So in a way, people would have thanked him and given him money, you know, as thanks for saving their lives. So I don't know why Naruto is still broke. Okay, so the whole Sakura novel thing happens, where someone impersonates Sasuke, and this is when we are introduced to people being able to genetically modify tail beast chakra pills. Okay, so once you take the pill in, you have the cloak, which can, you know, go up from 0 tails to 9. Okay, so that is really dangerous, and I will be talking about that later. And then we have the whole Konoha novel thingy where everyone was trying to prepare for Naruto's wedding and all that kind of stuff. So obviously I haven't read this novel yet, you know, so I cannot really go into depth as to what happens, but you've already seen the anime adaptation, so that is a rough, you know, summary of what happens. And then next to that we have the Gaara one. Okay, so the Gaara novel, and then there were a few people who actually thought that this novel was not canon, but it is. Okay, and then the next one is about the Akatsuki, so it's information about the Akatsuki as well as stories and all that kind of stuff. So if you really want to get into all that kind of stuff, you can check out this novel. What I will say is that these novels are really cheap. Okay, I'm not advertising all that kind of stuff, but you know what I'm saying. If you want extra info for your channel or anything, just look up the novels like I do. Okay, so next one is the Sasuke story, and in which he is looking for, you know, what was her name? I forgot her name, but it was the bitch Chino who used the Katsuriu gun. Okay, that whole story happened, and you know, there was this character who could, you know, create winds, you know, powerful enough to temporarily, you know, disable the Susanoo in some kind of way. Like Sasuke Susanoo, his perfect Susanoo, was struggling to keep up with the amount of wind that this guy was producing. So it goes to show that there are amazing ninja out there, but then again, Sasuke was holding back because if he was to, you know, slash with his Susanoo, he would have destroyed a huge area, and it is not the Sasuke from back in the day who did not give a fuck about human lives. So yeah, this Sasuke does care about his surroundings, and he was part of Konoha, or at least he's the Dark Hokage, right? So then after this we have Boruto the movie, but then within there a few things happen, and that is the anime, right? So let's go on to the next picture, okay, now, or the next poster, which, you know, tells you about the timeline. So as you can see, we can see here Naruto chapter 699 happens, right? And then after chapter 699 happens, so this is, you know, after Naruto and Sasuke have had their battle and everyone has been released from the Infinite Tsukuyomi, we have the last Naruto the movie happening, you know, which happens, I believe 2 years after the battle, something like that. And after that, you know, we have chapter 700 where, you know, we see the epilogue of what has happened to Naruto, him having kids and all that kind of stuff. And then this is the chapter that triggered every single person in the pairing war kind of thing, because some people got what they wanted and others didn't. And this is what I'm trying to emphasize with all these people in pairing wars. It's like, at the end of the day, it does not matter what you want, what pairing you want. The pairing that is going to happen is what the author wants. So basically trying to invest, you know, your time into something thinking it's going to happen when, you know, it's all up to the author is kind of a waste of time. Okay, so the next thing that happens obviously is the anime, right? And in the anime, you know, they have been adapted to novels. So we have novel one, which, you know, introduces Sumire and all that kind of stuff to us. And this is when, you know, I found the information that Sumire was an orphan and started to, you know, create, you know, Things You Missed videos and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that is the anime going on. And then we have novel two talks about, you know, a few things that Sumire did, so the past episodes and all that kind of stuff, right? Because I believe the first novel goes up to, I think, episode 7, okay? So novel one goes up to, I think, episode 7, and then novel 2 captures the whole Kage Masa bullshit happening, so it even covers the fillers and all that kind of stuff. And I think it will probably be, you know, continuing up until the Shin arc somewhere, and then they might, you know, sell a novel 3 if the novel 2 is successful. Okay, obviously these Boruto novels give information about things that are yet to come in the anime, so I think they are gonna be, you know, useful, because people will want to know, you know, things ahead of time before they are even released within the anime. Okay, so after that, right, I think if they are gonna do an arc after, you know, the Shin arc, then they might do that. But if they don't, then they are gonna skip straight into Boruto the movie. Okay, so we already know what happens in Boruto the movie, but we don't know what happens, you know, there are a few things that happen in the novel, you know, a few things, character interactions that have been cut out of there because of the whole pairing shit going on. Okay, now what I'm saying about the whole pairing thing is, right, is that, you know, there are a lot of key character interactions in there that they have taken away because, you know, it will ignite the pairing war thing, and they are kind of using it as a weapon or like a last resort, so people will be excited to find out who the main character ends up with. Personally, I don't give two fucks because it is a waste of time. Now the next one is Boruto Naruto the Next Generations, the manga. So this has to do with the whole you know, Mujina arc, where they are trying to find, I forgot the guy's name, but he's a cannibal, and you know, they are trying to find out what he is doing, or at least why he wants to catch the daimyo's son, right? So yeah, Boruto's a bodyguard and all that kind of stuff, and that pretty much summarizes the timeline for you right here. Now, as for the dates and stuff, I could not include that in there because, you know, I'm not really sure about all of them, but I will do some research and maybe even put it in the description below, who knows, right? But then again, I don't really have a lot of time to, you know, create a lot of videos. So this is what you get for the timeline. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, like, dislike, what did you like about it, and you know, maybe this clears up, you know, a few doubts that you had in terms of the timeline and all that kind of stuff. With that being said, I have nothing more to say. Subscribe and bye.